because we have an amazing woman here, you all.
Yes.
Governor Sarah Palin, you all. You all, she is a true patriot. I mean, and we call her sassy and classy. Yes, baby, yes. And she knows what she's talking about.
That's right.
And you know why we love her? Because she tells the truth. And we all can learn something from her, you all. We all can learn something from Governor Sarah Palin. So I want you all to put your hands together and welcome to the stage, Governor Sarah Palin.
Said, ma'am,
about our concerns for the future and our hopes for the future and about the American dream. And we talk a lot about what is at stake. And I'm reminding others that you don't need an office or a title to make a difference, as long as you will stand up and speak out and fight for what is right. Your activism is exactly that. I am amazed at events like this, especially beforehand when I get to meet many of you. And I see a couple here, a community college teacher who's here. They came from California to come to this event. And
she's talking about Jen Lovelatte.
Are like-minded, where we are greatly concerned about the future, and we want to be emboldened and empowered and enabled by others. As we look around and we see that we're not alone in this cause of supporting our duly elected president and the Make America Great Again agenda. So for now, the job that I have is absolutely wonderful, and I'm extremely thankful for your activism. It is exactly what is needed. In these times, it's a pretty mixed up world that we're in, and we're just trying to deal with a lot of pretty mixed up information in every news cycle, especially lately. These distractions and distortions and concocted collusions and Russia this and Russia that and Russia. It's stormy in Russia today. I warned all of you, though, back in 08, don't leave it all up to me to keep my eye on Putin from my house.
Right.
Exceptional. We were founded to be different. God-given rights, life, and liberty. And no politician, no government, no program would ever get to infringe on that. In fact, government would to exist to protect the right to life and liberty. And our Constitution's core is people entrusted to govern ourselves, and then the plurality of the electorate would make policy only, always, along those lines to protect liberties. And I don't know if the younger generation, I don't know if a whole lot of kids are learning that about America. So again, that's on us. Indelible to our identity, Samuel Huntington, he writes that we have, of course, these shared Judeo-Christian values that stress individual work ethic and charity from the goodness of our hearts, not Robin Hood's hand, and secure borders, because without borders you have no nation, and equal justice. Those make up our creed. Equal justice, and this is why I'm a Republican, this is why I'm still a Republican, despite my frustration sometimes with the machine that runs some parts of the party. I'm still a Republican because it's the GOP that has fought for equal justice, while Democrats fought against it every step of the way, from abolishing slavery to women's suffrage and our 13th, 14th, 15th amendments, and giving voice to the voiceless, the defense's most precious and sacred part of society, that's children in their mama's wombs. It's been conservative victories in those areas that the left has vehemently opposed, and it is fake history for our children to be taught otherwise. Our liberty and our unity and our prosperity and our purpose and our role as the leader in this world, leadership for good. And it is marked by stability and the overwhelming majority endorsement. Again, that makes us absolutely exceptional. Exceptional except in facing mortality. For just like every other society all throughout history, everyone, even the strongest of the strong, have at some point been threatened with extinction. And history is our teacher in this. Ergo, the lessons of Sparta and Rome and the other strong civilizations. We learn how even they met their demise. It's just like a home's foundation. When it loses integrity, when its supports are weakened by internal elements that are neglected, that had at one time been in order, so too society's foundation. When components, our components like united resiliency, when it's disregarded, well then the foundation will crumble, we will collapse. And adversaries of freedom that are really in some positions of power today, adversaries of freedom, they know that the hazards that will erode our base, our foundation, they will use those things like our social and economic and political differences to divide us. And they employ double standards and hypocrisy, and they think that we just won't notice, we won't realize their double standards. But they, being able to mar the beauty of diversity, what they're doing is trying to overload us and really rock our foundation until it does crumble, and it's from internal division. And remember, President Lincoln warned us about this. He said that no foreign force would ever defeat America. He said, if destruction be our lot, we ourselves will be the author and finisher. And that is why today's internal issues matter. And that's why we have to pay attention to politics. And it's why we put up with what we gotta put up with in politics. And not just think we can leave it up to someone else to tune in, to pay attention, and to stand up for what's right and do something about the problems. That's why it's on us. Today's internal attacks on our foundation, they will transform our identity. They'll exchange our identity for some kind of fungible one that's fitting any globalist agenda that's not going to be based on freedom and the American dream. That's going to succeed if we have not the will to win against anti even unspeakably horrific crimes, but these reactions that exploit, victimize children, and we see that all over the news recently. And shots on our U.S. solvency with pork duck bloated budgets. I hate to see Republican votes going towards these budgets. We pretending like deficits and debts, overwhelming, unsustainable, bankrupt debt, that they only matter when the Democrats hold the purse strings? We have to hold our own party accountable. And shots to our security if we engage in endless, windless wars where the elite want to send our sons and daughters to dangerous, far-off lands to nation build as parts of our own nation crumble, and we foot the bill thinking that we're going to clean up other people's messes before we sweep our own porch to make room for what matters here, like our vets, putting our vets first in line. And attacks on the workman's soul with disloyalty to the U.S. worker, as special interests on both sides of the aisle, they fight for our replacements with cheaper, less skilled foreign workers, which destabilizes the middle class and incentivizes illegal immigration with no expectation of assimilation, and that is a globalist agenda to devalue citizenship. You know, you watch what's going on there and you think, come on, good Lord, GOP, you are in charge. You know that our president, each cabinet member, they have discretionary funds and they can use their discretion, they can use the funds, and they also have the power over our party. They need to wield it so we don't have to keep asking things like, where's the wall?
Yep.
We're asking, where's the wall? We are in charge, and we have to remind them of this. And we do have to remember, too, especially when we see our president just getting clobbered in the news left and right, without a lot of people who are around him, should be around him, protecting him and being his surrogate. He has to get out there and say some things that we think, oh my gosh, why did he tweet that? Why do you have to say that? Because he has to say that, because nobody's doing it for him. So. Spokesperson for this grand populism that represents all races and backgrounds that have just been really fed up with the politics of the past, with the swamp, as we watch the swamp bankrolling campaigns and really setting the political landscape for their interests, for their special interests, not the American interests. So in 2016, remember, we chose one who we felt knew what was at stake and could speak for us. We knew that it would take someone from outside this DC bubble to pierce it and be our voice to demand accountability, to do something about the bad actors and the broken system. It all had to be different, because the status quo will never fix itself. And boy, oh boy, has it turned out to be different. All these folks going rogue now, you know. I'm not getting a president going rogue. That's what we needed for a long time.
Yeah.
The cause is great, though, so it makes you wonder why in the world would the powerful want things going on? Why do they want to change all of this so? Why do they want to undo the progress that's being made with their promise to fundamentally transform America, which by definition is very radical? Transformation means to destroy something and replace it with something completely different. You transform something for which you have disdain. It's the one promise that Obama made, he announced, and he sure tried hard to keep. It's all about control for those adversaries of freedom who want to transform this country into something unrecognized. recognizable. They would overturn the will of the people with an agenda that really is the antithesis of the American dream based on freedom. And now, of course, they're unhinged. They're unhinged because this awakening really ripped the veil off the corrupt power and wealth system that betrayed the people for far too long. It exposed complicity of the professional political class and the enablers who benefit. And the people's movement that elected Donald Trump, the people's movement is their existential threat. And that's why they want it, they need it destroyed. To destroy it, their tactic is to divide us. And to divide, they distract. The real threat isn't if a private citizen, messed around, had an affair, whatever, with a consenting partner years and years ago. We've had men in office, literally in the office, too much worse. And I don't excuse any of that by, repeating what some Neanderthals still say, oh, boys will be boys. Boys will be boys. That's why they shouldn't run the world. Now the tactic, friends, is to wear you down with these distractions and scandal after scandal and compound it all, hoping that you just give up and wave the white flag of surrender and say, it's just too much. Too much is overwhelming. My little activism, what difference at this point does it make? Well, now is when it matters. Even when you get tired, even when you're ticked at our leaders, the politicians, take the easy route and ignore the real problems, remember that activism is your purpose, and without it, without vision, the people perish. So too a nation. Our country is in epic battle over visions today. One is dark and divisive, and the trajectory is decline. And the other is uplifting and life-sustaining, and it's unifying, and it builds with the optimistic, pioneering spirit of free men and free market that has endured in this country. And going forward, you decide in this battle which vision wins. In 6 months, we have opportunity to wrest control from a failed political establishment whose interests do run counter to the interests of the American people. The upcoming midterms, they're going to decide the entire House and a third of the Senate and 36 governorships across the nation and all those attorney general seats and legislative seats and local seats. This is talking from veto power to subpoena power to blocking nominees to redistricting lines and more gridlock or no gridlock. The vote is monumental and it's going to affect generations beyond us. And the Uniparty, they are poised to pounce. They are loaded for bear. So you cannot go hibernate, not at this time. With power and control and trillions of dollars at stake, they're not going to give up any of their power and control civilly. They're going to use every resource to blow up the Trump train. And it is on us to know and to show what is at stake. It's our solvency, our sovereignty, it is your freedom. So even when tired, and look around, and realize that you are not alone. And if you strengthen your spine, you're going to see that others around you, they'll strengthen their spine, and they can be hope-filled. We can be hope-filled, happy warriors. And maybe that old Uniparty posse that has ended up staffing MSNBC newsroom for the most part, those back in 08 who now say they regret choosing an independent, common-sense conservative to run for vice president, maybe it's for the same reason that some, have been able to kind of infiltrate around themselves around our president exert some influence on some agenda, because some powers that be, they know that people like you, people like me, we owe our allegiance to our God-inspired Constitution, not to one power.
Oh!
is right, and you already do know. So thank you for being here and just take that advice.
Thank you, Grayson. That was great. Your parents are also great for bringing you here.
Good evening, Governor Palin. It's a pleasure to have you here tonight. My name is Joanne Chase, and I'm a member of the National Diversity Coalition for Trump. And I've got a question for you. Do you think that President Trump made the right
decision? Donald Trump, you were there. The Dynasty guys were there, so I knew it was going to be a good one. And we were there saying what a bogus deal it was. The funny thing is how many Democrats even back then were also, even Schumer, they were saying like, yeah, Obama, this deal, and it's not going to be good for America. And then what are they doing today? You know, they're slamming us, they're slamming Trump for having gotten out of the deal. No, it's amazing that Donald Trump fulfills his promises, and that's another reason that the obstructionists are going berserk, because I think they've seen a politician like Trump who will actually govern as he campaigned. They don't know what to do with someone who keeps their promises.
The concerns are rising because of the conflicts in the Middle East. How important do you think it is for America to continue to look for new oil reserves to preserve our future?
Oh, I could talk about this all night. I'm so busy. We're going to go right on back to drip, baby, drill.
Yeah.
Reserves that God has created for mankind's responsible use. America has, and not just in Alaska, but all over this great land. We are so rich in natural resources, we do not have to rely on foreign countries who do use energy as a weapon and manipulate the prices and, of course, the supply. We can be energy independent. So, again, thank you, Jesus. Our healthcare system.
especially in some states like California, who are just trying to live through what's being brought down on them by the administration out there. And sanctuary cities are just a terrible idea, in my opinion. I wondered what your thoughts were, and if you've seen any of this ramification reaching outside of California, and wondering, are we doing enough? Can we do more to make this issue something we can all agree on instead of being a divisive one automatically?
Yeah, it's a really bizarre issue, the sanctuary cities, and as our friends from California, as we were able to discuss earlier this evening, there are some enclaves, there are some pockets there in California who understand what is going on with the unconstitutionality of these mayors and their governors saying it's okay to disregard federal law especially that keeps citizens secure. I think one of the greatest ramifications is there's such greater awareness now in California. I have people all the time there who are saying they don't want to go the secession route. You know, as so many of the liberal Californians saying, well, we'll just go out and create our own country. No, because you know, good patriotic Californians know how much their state has to contribute to America as a whole. California is such an amazing state, and it is just supplied with all the most wonderful natural resources and talent, and they're just really missing out by being illegal and led by some numbskulls. You know, they're led by, I think, you know, the worst politicians in our nation happen to come from California, but there is so much more awareness now. California, a lot of the churches in those areas, they're rising up saying, no, you know, we want to participate in for the good of the order in making sure their constitution is protected. They really, really need to change leadership left and right there.
And with that, I think a standing ovation is in order. One more for yourselves. This has been a fantastic event.